Well, despite the snow falling, today is the official start of spring, and if you want to give your home a facelift this season, a fresh coat of paint may not be the best place to start. Exterior remodeling expert Charles Thayer with All Around is here to talk about the biggest remodeling trends of 2018. Welcome. It's good to have you here today.
Thanks for having me, Pat.
There's a lot happening in this arena. What do people typically want to tackle exterior-wise on the house?
Well, everybody's really excited to get out there and start tackling those exterior projects, but we want to keep in mind that adding curb appeal is really the goal, and there's certain ways to do that that are a lot easier than others.
And the good news is, because fabrication of some things that have been very expensive, like this is an example here in the old days, this is very expensive to go and machine all this stuff. Now it's made of these synthetic materials and it lasts indefinitely, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Around the Twin Cities, we're seeing more and more demand for more detail within siding projects. Mm-hmm. So things like what we used to see in the early 1900s, trim work, staggered edge shakes, corbels, stone accents, they may seem like small details, but they do so much when it comes to curb appeal.
We have some pictures on the screen now. Tell us what we're looking at here.
You're looking at a lot of detail with trim and staggered edge shakes. And the awesome thing about materials nowadays compared to over 100 years ago is that they can be pre-finished in a factory as opposed to painted on site. And that just really means that they're going to last so much longer.
That shingle work is just beautiful on that. All the different interest of layers of texture you get with some of this stuff was really pretty terrific as well. So that's one grouping of things. And there's other areas that are big that we're going to take a look at now that folks increasingly are willing to put a little bit of money in. Let's take a look and see what's next here.
Yeah, surprisingly, under your deck is a huge wasted space for a lot of people. So we're getting more and more requests at All Around for something called underdecking. Underdecking is quite simply adding a ceiling underneath your deck. And it also keeps the air, it looks fantastic, first of all, and it keeps the area underneath the deck dry. You can also add things like lights, ceiling fans, or even speakers that'll complement an outdoor living space like a kitchen or spa.
Well, this is really beautiful what you're showing us here. It really makes for another room then.
It really
does. You know, completely, and it's so bright and nice rather than looking at all the dark spaces under it. Is this expensive to do?
You bet. I mean, it isn't cheap, I'll say that. I would say your average deck somewhere between $4,000 and $8,000. Mm-hmm. But again, it gives you that extra living space. It looks fantastic, and it drains water away from your house the way it's supposed to.
Which is really nice. We're looking at, what is this, right? Is this an example
of
that right here?
This is the Inside Out product by Quality Edge, and as you can see right here, it's an example of a deck on top with the panels underneath, and those are all designed to channel water into a built-in drainage system.
There is so much going on now in your business. Exciting for you to be working in it. We're looking last, giving curb appeal with the new front door.
Yeah, you know, adding curb appeal doesn't have to break the bank. Adding a new front door is a great feature that doesn't have to break the bank, and it's also one of the best return on investments. And you could just basically supersize that by doing a new garage door. We're seeing a lot of demand for designer style steel garage doors.
Well, Charles Thayer, you're the founder of All Around. We appreciate you being here today. Hope it's a good and busy season for you folks.
Thank you so much for having me.
Our pleasure. We have more information on remodeling trends at care11.com. Look for the 4 p.m. show page under the menu section.